sites in the ACE gene polymorphism with essential hypertension in the Sudanese patients. This research was supervised by Professor Abdelrahim Osman and Professor Janet Edman from Germany. Background, hypertension, as you all know, is a chronic disease and it has two types, primary and secondary. In this research, we were mainly interested in the primary hypertension. You all know that hypertension has many complications, cardiovascular, renal, and retinopathy, so it's important to be studied, and always more researches are needed regarding the pathophysiology. In the pathophysiology of hypertension, it is known that the part of the pathophysiology is about atherosclerosis, and atherosclerosis involved endothelial dysfunction. And one of the important molecules that is important for the functional integrity of the endothelium is nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is synthesized by the nitric oxide synthase in the endothelium. When nitric oxide is synthesized, it is released to the smooth muscle, where it activates GTP into cyclic GMP. And then cyclic GMP is important to mediate vascular dilatation and decrease platelet aggregation and decrease leukocyte aggregation. So if there is a decreased nitric oxide, this will lead to vasoconstriction, this will lead to platelet aggregation, it will lead to leukocyte, and this will lead to endothelial dysfunction. So, and it is known that hypertension has a genetic basis, and actually around 25 to 60% is due to genetic causes. So studying this gene, the endothelial nitric oxide synthase gene, it seems like an interesting candidate gene to study. This gene is present in chromosome 7, and we are interested in three different variants. One in the promoter region, it is a single nucleotide polymorphism from T to C, and then we are also we're interested in a second variant at intron 4, it's a deletion, and also in exon 7, it is a single nucleotide polymorphism. So the aim of this study is to investigate the association between these three different polymorphisms and their association with hypertension in the Sudanese population. So we took 155 patients, hypertensive patients, and 85 controls. The hypertensive patients were either established or newly diagnosed. We excluded any patients with secondary hypertension. Also, we excluded hypertensive who have any inflammatory disorders because it may interfere with the level of the nitric oxide. Controls were adults with normal blood pressure and no family history and no other diseases. So we took blood samples of these patients around 10 ml, and then we did DNA extraction, and then we did genotyping of the endothelial nitric oxide synthase gene using two techniques, TAGMAN and PCR and RFNP, restriction fragment length polymorphism. Regarding the TAGMAN technique, the variant in the promoter region, it gave very clear result, as you can see, three different clouds indicating the three different genotypes, but the one in the exon 7, it failed to give good results. So for the one which were not determined by the TAGMAN, we used the PCR RFNP. For example, in the promoter region, you can see the different band length indicating the different genotypes. Also here for the variant in the exon 7, we used two restriction enzymes. And for the one in the intron 4, we didn't use any enzymes because it is two variants indicating two different lengths. So for the normal person, you have a repeat, which is 27 nucleotide repeated 5 times. And the minor allele or the minor, it is a deletion. Instead of 4 repeats, it's only 3 repeats. So and the two alleles will give two different fragments of two different lengths. So for the result, as we said, 155 hypertensive and 85 controls. For the one in the promoter region, regarding the genotype distribution, we found actually that the TT genotype is more common in the control, while the CC genotype is more common in the hypertensive, and it gave a significant result. When we studied the genotype distribution regarding the recessive and dominant model, also the dominant model showed a significant increase of the TCCC genotype in the hypertensive group. Allele frequency also was significant, as T was more in the control, while the C allele was more in the hypertensive, and the result was also significant. For the one in the intron 4, the genetic distribution was insignificant. Also for the one in the exon 7, also the genetic distribution showed no significant differences between hypertensive and controls. So So in summary, we found that the variation from 2 to C in the promoter region, it was significantly associated with essential hypertension in the Sudanese population. The variation in intron 4 and exon 7 were not significantly associated with hypertension in the Sudanese population. So we recommend further studies to confirm our results and characterize the molecular mechanism by which the variation in the promoter region is involved.